For more than a decade, Samsung and its Galaxy line have been the king of Android smartphones. In 2009, the company made up less than 3% of global smartphone market share. In 2023, the company hovers around 20%, has the highest market share of any single Android manufacturer, and trades blows with Apple for the number one spot. Samsung succeeded when numerous others tried and failed over the past 15 years. But what's the story of the company's phenomenal rise in the Android world? Today we find out how Samsung became a global smartphone leader, outperforming other tech giants in its journey to the top. In the early 2000s, Samsung was famous for its TVs and appliances, but decided to enter the smartphone world after seeing the success of the iPhone. The company's first Android smartphone was the original Samsung Galaxy, which launched in June 2009. With a 3.2-inch AMOLED display, the company immediately differentiated itself from the iPhone, with the screen offering higher contrast and deep, inky blacks. In 2010, Samsung launched the Galaxy S, starting a smartphone line that continues even today. The phone was revolutionary for the time, with a large 4-inch Super AMOLED display and a power VR GPU that was the fastest in the world. At 9.9mm, the Galaxy S was also the thinnest smartphone available. The phone was a commercial success, with over 25 million units sold globally. In the US, Samsung benefited from Apple's exclusivity contract with AT&T, since the iPhone was not available on other carriers until early 2011. The Samsung Galaxy S2, released in April 2011, marked a significant milestone in Samsung's smartphone evolution. Known for its sleek design, the Galaxy S2 was one of the thinnest smartphones of its time, measuring just 8.5mm in thickness. Under the hood, it featured a dual-core processor, making it one of the fastest phones available. And it came equipped with an 8-megapixel rear camera that delivered high-quality photos and 1080p video recording, which was also revolutionary for the time. The phone was a huge success, with over 20 million units sold less than a year after its release. The Galaxy S2 also played a pivotal role in cementing Samsung's position in the smartphone market, with the company's market share surpassing 20% by the end of 2011. In October 2011, Samsung unveiled the Galaxy Note, which created an entirely new category of smartphones with its 5.3-inch Super AMOLED display. This screen was very large for the time, and combined with the S Pen stylus, the device was ideal for note-taking, drawing, and multitasking. By combining a tablet and smartphone into a single form factor, the Galaxy Note was a bold move by Samsung, and that paid off, with over 10 million units sold within a year. Launched in May 2012, the Galaxy S3 was a revolutionary step forward in the Galaxy S series, and a major success in the smartphone market. The device was an all-around solid phone, with a 720p 4.8-inch Super AMOLED display, a quad-core processor, an 8-megapixel rear camera, and a sleek design. With 70 million units shipped worldwide, the Galaxy S3 is one of the best-selling Android smartphones of all time. But the S3 wasn't just a commercial success. It was a statement by Samsung and showed the company's ability to compete with the iPhone at the pinnacle of smartphone innovation. Following the S3's success, the company then launched the Galaxy Note 2 in September 2012, and the Galaxy S4 in April 2013, which solidified Samsung's dominance in the high-end Android smartphone market. The Note 2 built on the success of its predecessor, with a larger screen and improved stylus. The Galaxy S4 was a major step up, with a 1080p display and 13-megapixel rear camera. Both were extremely popular, with 30 million Note 2s and 70 million S4s sold globally. This period from 2012 to 2014 represented the peak of Samsung's dominance in the global smartphone market. The company's market share hovered just above 30%, it was unrivaled among Android manufacturers, and even had twice the market share of second-placed Apple. The most impressive part of Samsung's rise is that the company managed to overcome significant competition from other Android OEMs, such as HTC, Sony, and LG. Samsung's grip on the industry is so strong that these three companies are now mostly irrelevant in the smartphone market. There are four key reasons why Samsung was able to succeed at the expense of its rivals. The first component of Samsung's strategy was to have a diverse product range. From budget models like the Galaxy Y to premium devices like the Galaxy S and Note lines, the company aims to have something for everyone. This was something that Sony in particular failed to do, with many of its phones criticized for being too expensive. The second reason for Samsung's success is that the company poured enormous resources into R&D for its smartphone business. In 2014, Samsung spent over $13 billion in R&D, which was the second highest of any company in the world. This allowed it to stay on the cutting edge, releasing well-packaged phones with innovative features. Given the size of Samsung, its rivals simply struggled to compete in the long term. The third part of Samsung's strategy was its marketing and brand recognition. This may have been the biggest driver of the company's success. Specifically, Samsung started out aggressively targeting Apple, the standard bearer in the industry. The Next Big Thing campaign in the United States, which promoted the Galaxy S2 and S3 series, is just one example of this. Samsung was also willing to pay to reach large audiences, with multiple Super Bowl commercials in the US. Even in recent years, the Samsung logo is often prominently displayed in Times Square. By contrast, HTC, Sony, and LG have struggled to match Samsung's marketing success. With a motto of quietly brilliant, HTC was not as aggressive in showing off its products compared to the competition. The company then spent $1 billion on an ad campaign starring Robert Downey Jr., which failed to reverse its fortunes. Sony as well did not promote its Xperia line in key markets, which when combined with its high prices, contributed to low sales. While LG did focus on boosting its marketing in 2014, the company had already slid behind Samsung in terms of product awareness by that time. The final component of Samsung's success was the company's ability to adapt and set market trends. The clearest example of this is the launch of the Note line, which kickstarted a push towards large screen phones that Samsung capitalized on. More recently, the company was one of the first to launch devices with curved and foldable screens. This ability to steer and adapt to the market is something that Samsung's rivals were unable to do. HTC tried to craft an identity around high-quality speakers with the original HTC One, but this didn't catch on in the industry. The results were similar when LG tried to differentiate itself with removable batteries and expandable storage. After 2014, Samsung began to see stronger competition from Apple with the launch of the iPhone 6 Plus, which peeled away Samsung's dominance among larger phones. Chinese manufacturers also became larger players in the global smartphone market, first Huawei, then Xiaomi, and then Oppo. As a result, Samsung's market share dipped to 20-25%, which is where it's been ever since. The most acute threat to Samsung's dominance was the Galaxy Note 7, which launched in August 2016. Although the phone initially had positive reviews, it posed a significant safety hazard. 2 weeks after release, there were many reports of battery explosions, which led to a global recall and Samsung issuing replacements. Eventually, replacement units began to explode as well, and by October 2016, Samsung announced it would permanently stop production of the model. This incident was a major setback for Samsung and may have led to a 33% drop in the company's quarterly operating profits. But while the fiasco may have sunk a smaller company, Samsung's position was so dominant that it was able to maintain its place in the industry. Today, Samsung remains a leader in the Android market. The company's commitment to being on the forefront of innovation continues, with the introduction of foldable phones through the Galaxy Fold series. Samsung is also focused on improving its software support, one of the most criticized parts of its previous devices. In October 2023, the company promised 3 to 4 years of Android version updates and security updates for a wide range of devices. Looking ahead, Samsung is positioned to continue as a major player in the space, with more foldable devices, integration with smart home products, and potentially exciting features such as AI. Long term, the company's biggest challenge is holding off competition from firms like Xiaomi and Oppo that offer high quality, low cost devices. Apple as well remains a perennial competitor in the upper end of the market. But given how the past 15 years have gone, Samsung likely has what it takes to maintain its strength. What part of Samsung's road to dominance are you most impressed by? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. drop a like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. I'll see everyone next time.